Let's see how you can create realistic water inside Blender and even add foam to it. So here I've a simple scene with a soil and a sunlight. First, create a cube and scale it on the Z-axis. And don't forget to apply the scale by pressing Ctrl plus A, rotation and scale. Now let's work on the shader. Go on your shader editor, create a new material, delete the principled BSDF and add a glass shader. So Shift plus A and search for glass and connect it to the surface here. Search for a transparent shader. We are going to mix these two shaders together with a mix shader. So Shift plus A and type mix shader. You can now connect the shaders. Here on the factor socket, search light path. Connect the is shadow ray. Next, we can create waves with a noise texture. So search for noise texture. And connect the factor with the normal socket of the glass material. Let's add a bump between the two nodes and connect the noise to the height. Increase the scale and add a bit more detail here. Small correction. I've put a translucent node here instead of a transparent node, so be careful not to make the same mistake. To add some depth to our shader, let's add a volume absorption to the volume socket here. The denser it is, the more depth your water will have. We can now add an add shader node to the volume here. Plug the volume absorption to the second socket, and here on the first we can add a principled BSDF. Change the color to a green or blue. We can do the same for the volume absorption as well. Go back to the glass material and change the IOR here to 1.333, which is the water index of refraction. Next, let's work on the foam part. Add a new mix shader here. Switch the connection here to the bottom shader socket. In this socket, add a principled BSDF. We are going to use a noise texture with a ramp color. Plug this to the color channel and play with the values of the noise and ramp. Now we can mix the two shaders by adding the ambient occlusion node. Plug the AO channel to the factor here. Add a ramp color as well. Next, add a noise texture to the normal socket of the ambient occlusion. Add a ramp color between each other to control the noise and modify the scale of the noise. You can also increase the details of the noise. I'm also changing the distance value of the ambient occlusion. Let's decrease it, and also play with the ramp color here to have something more subtle. Now you can play with the different values here to find exactly what you need. So that's it. I hope this was helpful. See you in the next video.